about yourself. And the helicopter is just going to take off from the right-hand end of the runway for much of 1942. So here it is, the P-40. Watch out for the sun. And isn't that absolutely perfect? How lucky we are to be able to see this kind of thing. And here, the sound of the Halicon P-12. You may want to look at the colour scheme on this aircraft. It's the colours of the Tuskegee Airmen, the first all Afro-American flying group, also known as the Red Tails, although this aircraft doesn't actually have a red tail, more about that for now. That really is a perfect sound, the sound of the V-12. So the Tuskegee Airmen were based in southern Italy, 1944-45, repeated action over Nazi-occupied territory. They flew P-40s before moving on to the P-51 Mustang, one of which we shall see later. Peter Teichmann, who owns this aircraft, has just come back from 2 weeks filming in Prague on a new big budget movie called Red Tails, produced by George Lucas. A lovely barrel roll there, described by Peter, the barrel roll, getting its name from the fact that the aircraft describes the outline of a barrel lying along the display axis. So this new film, Red Tails, tells the story of these famous airmen who never lost a B-17 on escort duties over enemy territory. And Peter flew this B-40 on the film set in Milovice near Prague, where the aircraft had been painted in these authentic colours together with full battle aging so that it looks exactly like it would look when it comes back off a mission. Decided to keep the colours on the aircraft because he likes the look of it, keeping this paint show on for the rest of the season. Peter learned to fly about 25 years ago, intending to go and be an airline pilot, but he got sidetracked into being an entrepreneur, he says modestly, which meant that he could fly more interesting aircraft than driving a big jet to Mallorca and back. Very experienced, Peter Teichmann, in heavy warbirds. He owns, look at that, he owns, as well as this aircraft, a Spitfire and a Mustang, and he has just this year achieved his ambition of getting a Hurricane as well. He feels it's very important that a plane should have a little wheel at the back. Family are quite supportive of him being away most weekends, displaying his aircraft all around the country. Except that his wife thinks that old planes should be in a museum, along with their old pilots, but we're very glad that he's here with us today. P-40 first saw action when Major General Claire Chennault formed the American volunteer group which came to be known as the Flying Tigers, and that was before the US actually came into the war. Effort by President Roosevelt to keep China out of the hands of the Japanese. So basically they were mercenaries, three P-40 squadrons operating in China to protect airfields and supply lines against the invading Japanese. P-40 was outclassed by the Japanese Zero, but the Tigers relied on hit-and-run tactics, and in spite of overwhelming odds they were able to claim 286 Japanese aircraft for the loss of only 84. These aircraft at North Weald in his Hangar 11 collection. The connection with the Flying Tigers suffered a loss a year ago. Rita Wong, who was the only Chinese nurse looking after wounded Flying Tigers, she died last year at the age of 95. Like Neville Duke of 112 Squadron, who incidentally also died not long ago, flew these Kitty Hawks in the North African desert. They wound the production down on these aircraft in 1944, and a total of 13,783 P-40s have been built. And this is the only one left flying this side of the Atlantic. And went to the Royal Canadian Air Force, where it flew with several squadrons before being demobbed in 1950. Became an instructional aircraft at Oregon State University, and then went into storage, found in the late 70s. Very well preserved. Last pass from Peter Teichmann.